Hello, I am Piyali Ghoshal. Presently, I am working in a FMCG organization as a microbiologist, and I am really thankful to respected Abhijit sir for giving me an opportunity in the Pharma Awareness Channel. Thank you, sir. And I also want to request all of you to drop your feedback and questions in the comment box. Thank you. So today I want to discuss about the fungal staining methods, like what is fungus, basic principle of fungal staining, how we can prepare fungal staining in lab, and also how we can observe and identify the fungus under the microscope. So now I am going to start with my first point, that is, what is fungus? The fungus is actually a member of the group of eukaryotic organisms that includes microorganisms such as yeast, mold, etc. Okay. So we all know about mushrooms. This mushrooms is also a type of fungus also. As I told you that the fungus is the member of eukaryotic cell, thus these also have cell with proper nuclei. Also, the cell wall of fungus contains chitin, unlike the cell wall of plant, which contains cellulose. Okay. And coming to my second point, that is basic principle of fungus staining. So before starting this point, we all have to know that what is the stain and what is staining, right? Staining is a technique where we use some chemicals to impart color to the different components of the cell to study the structural details of the cell. Okay. And the chemical which we use is called stain, and the process is called staining process. Fungal staining is a very short and a very easy method, and there are mainly three types of method which we generally use for the fungal staining, and these methods are: the first method is lactophenol cotton blue method, or this method is also known as LPCB method, which is most widely used in all fields. The second method is periodic acid sieve method, or this is also known as PAS method. And the third and last one is the periodic acid sieve and Gomari methanamine silver method, or this is also known as PAS and GMS method. Now coming to the next point, that is, how we can prepare fungal stain in laboratory. Lactophenol cotton blue can be prepared by using the composition as I am going to tell you. That is, phenol crystal we have to take 20 gram, cotton blue we have to take 0.05 gram, and lactic acid 20 ml, glycerol 20 ml, and distilled water also we have to take 20 ml. Now we have to know about the function of all these chemicals which we are using to prepare the stain. The first one which we are using, that is lactic acid. The role of lactic acid is, lactic acid preserves the fungal structure and also makes the tissue clear so that we can easily observe under microscope. The second one is phenol. Phenol acts as a fungicidal or a disinfectant which kills the live organisms and prevent the contamination. And the third one is cotton blue. Cotton blue mainly stains the chitin of the fungal cell wall. Okay, now I am going to describe step-by-step procedure for fungal staining. In this procedure, first we have to take a clean glass slide, then we have to add 1 to 2 drop of lactophenol cotton blue reagent on the clean and dry slide. Then we have to carefully transfer a mycelial mat on the fluid through a sterile needle and press it gently so that the mat easily mixes with the stain. In the next step, we have to carefully spread the fungal mycelia and have to make a thin preparation. Now place a cover slip on the preparation by avoiding any air bubble, and then blot dry the excess stain, and now we can observe under the microscope. If we observe this slide under the microscope, we can easily observe the proper structure of fungal mycelia under the microscope, and we can also observe the spore of the fungus if it is present in the fungal mycelian mat. Okay. So basically, this was a very small informative discussion about the fungal staining methods and all, and I hope you all like this, and please It's my request. Don't forget to give your feedback in the comment section. Thank you.